The construction of this balun is so simple. You want a piece of tubing, plastic tubing, about 1 inch in outside diameter. And then you wind 12 turns of wire by filer. That means you have two of them. So there's the first one. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. Then you wind another one with it as well. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. And you take the top of one, join it to the bottom. That then, this is your coaxial feeder. And there's your center connector. There's your braid. The braid connects to there. This point can also be connected to ground. This point here goes up and connects to your ladder line. That's your ladder line. This point here connects to the other side of your ladder line. So that becomes your balanced output. This can be 10, 12 or 14 gauge thickness wire. Apparently if you use 10 gauge wire it will take the American legal limit, whatever that is, a kilowatt. I've tested it, I've built mine with 14 gauge PVC coated wire and I've tested it to 200 watts. Apparently this balun is good from 3 megahertz up to 30 megahertz. No need to worry about permeability of the core because it's just plastic. Very, very cheap to make and seems to work very well. A 4-to-1 balun. Well, here's a closer look at the 4-to-1 balun. I've taken it out of its little casing so you can see. What I've done, I fitted an SO239 socket there. And here you can see the bifiler winding. I believe that you can actually twist these together if you want, but I just interwound them like that. I've used sort of grey or black and white wires. It's important to use different coloured wires so you can see how it goes then. And here's your balanced outputs. You basically just wind 12 turns on a 1-inch plastic former and then you connect the top darker coloured wire to the bottom lighter coloured wire, and then that all goes to ground or to shield of the coax or both. You can actually ground the antenna at this point or take a ground wire to give the antenna ground potential and a path of DC current to go. The other wire is connected to the centre coaxial connector and also taken to the balanced output. And the other white wire there is the other balanced output. Right, time to put it back in its case. The case is just a little plastic bottle that was used for storing vitamin C chewable tablets. And I cut the thread off because I'm going to push the two together and then to simply tape it. I don't want to be pushing that in and then turning it and causing it all to twist. Two holes drilled here to allow these screws to come up throughout to give me the terminal posts for connection to the ladder line. Well, what you see here is the finished balun. Just taped it up with some duct tape. Seems to be quite good stuff that, actually. Not especially a neat job, but electrically it will do what I want it to do. There's your unbalanced input. There's your balanced output. A 4-to-1 balun. All you have to do now is connect the balanced output to the ladder line. As I do that, just starting to rain. Connect the coax.